Hi, I'm Heather at the Kraaft Shaak, where we believe all were created by the Creator to be creative. Join me now for another art adventure.
Well, hello and welcome to Heather's Art Adventure. So this is a previously recorded live stream from my Twitch channel, and I have edited it down and obviously sped it up because my hands don't move that fast normally, of a challenge I proposed to myself. I wanted to see if I could get 12 ATCs done in 1 hour. An ATC is an artist trading card, and it's they're defined by their size, which is 2.5 inches by 3.5 inches. And I had lots of scraps on my desk, as you see. These are all little pieces of, which normally would be trash. And I kept it all and said, okay, I'm going to take this cover from this watercolor pad and use that as my base. And then with gel medium, I'm gluing down all of these scraps. And there's like tissue paper. This is actually pattern paper, which is, you know, very tissue-like. It just kind of adds a little layer of transparency, but mostly texture, really. It's just sort of adding to that background, covering up some of the words with the less transparent tissue papers, and then scraps from previous projects I had done. And basically what I was trying to do was use up those scraps instead of throwing them away and prove to myself that it didn't have to have rhyme or reason. And we had a great conversation while we were doing all of this, so it's always a fun thing to enjoy our time together during the live streams. And then now that it's 2021, I am making it a commitment to my YouTube channel to take some of these videos and turn them into these quicker videos. So hopefully you like this. I've debated over doing these videos like this, like I'm currently doing it with a voiceover, or just adding music and letting you watch while the music plays. But you let me know down in the comments which you prefer, and we'll see which way it ends up. But chances are it'll probably be those who, the highest number of votes will win, probably. But anyway, so yeah, these are just like little bits of napkins, and I mean, really, there was no rhyme to it. It was just junk that was on my table at the time, and the whole goal was to get it done as quick as possible, make something pretty, but to have at least 12 ATCs when I was done in about 1 hour's time. Now, for this video and for the videos that I'm going to be putting on YouTube, I do cut out like the drying time. So hopefully you can kind of tell that it's not wet anymore. And I cut out the drying time, as well as like the comments on screen and all that fun stuff that happens while we are live. So using a little bit of gesso and then some water to sort of give it a wash, we're going to push that background back into the background and make it a little bit more cohesive, so it's all basically got one starting point. And that'll make it easier for our colors to come out a little truer and hide the fact that that is an old watercolor pad of paper cover. And you just see me spreading the watered down gesso out with the paintbrush, and willy-nilly, quick as pie, there it goes. Why do people say quick as pie? Pie is not quick. It's not quick to make pie. Anyway, so of course we're going to cut out the drying time, and before we do that, I wiped it back some with baby wipes because I felt like I just put down too much and covered up all that stuff. So yeah, wipe it back with baby wipe. Yeah. Kind of fun to rewatch some of these too. Like, I think this one is from like September of 2019. So going back in the vault a little bit, I've got a couple of these videos. I'm going to be putting them out Every Friday is my goal, is to put out one of these edited videos every Friday to YouTube. And if you notice that there are comments and already some views on it when you go to watch it, let me tell you a secret. Those folks who have joined our members-only website have the link ahead of time, a couple of days ahead of time, in our Discord over on the in our community over on Discord. And hopefully that's a nice little perk that they didn't even know they were going to get. And if you're watching this and you're a member, leave a comment down below and let everybody know that you got to watch this first. Nanner, nanner, boo-boo. All right, so using some golden paints. I love the golden fluid acrylics, because they are very, very vibrant in color. So you see that I put down like a turquoise, and then the green gold, and then now this is quinacridone, nickel, azo, gold. And I just love how they work together. I did use a brayer for the first two colors, just because I thought it would give it a little different texture, but I didn't use enough paint for it to do that, and I didn't want to cover it up, because the turquoise color is more opaque, so it would have covered up more. And you'll see as I put it in here, it's more opaque, so we got to use it more sparingly is what I'm trying to say. And I wanted these colors to go together because I was looking at my Donna Downey inspiration journal before I had done this, and there's a couple of pages where we had this sort of mix of color, and I love that combination. I don't know why, but I do. So in my journey of mixed media, I have this sort of formula that I follow. It's like a five-step plan. I'm doing a video on that too, by the way. But in those five stages, or five steps, I guess, to a mixed media page, stamping is in there. And I'm using an art foamy and some of that white gesso left over from the first layer, and stamping these cool leaves in random order. This is my favorite part about making ATCs, is that you take this horrific looking background. I mean, truly, there's nothing beautiful about this, but it's sort of becoming so. But the best part of it is that it's going to be individual pieces of that. So it looks random and chaotic, and like there's no overall tying it together, whatever. It doesn't matter, because in the end, it's just going to be a small 2.5 by 3.5 section of this whole thing, which makes it its own individual little art piece. And so layers and layers, and just sort of doing it all over the place. I think the key, though, is to make sure that you get a little bit of each element that you add into each area where there's going to be a ATC. So, for example, right now what I'm doing is spreading this this adhesive that's for foiling. I believe it's a Rebecca Meyer adhesive that's specifically for her foil sheets. And that's all from ThermoWeb. And I don't know that they sell that stuff anymore, because I've tried finding a replacement bottle and it's not easy. Amazon had it at one point, and then I went to buy it and it was gone. But they do have other products too, but I've found some different glues that work. But anyway, I'm using this glue through a stencil, and you see how I'm just making sure I get it on the element is on every portion of the page. And that's to make sure, or to ensure, that each individual ATC will have a piece of that, or a part of that. And the cool thing about this glue, which is why I was looking for it, is that, you know, you put it on like this, you can take your time, you can go quick, you can go fast, doesn't matter. Then you let it dry, and I've even used the heat tool to let it dry, but see how milky it is at this moment? And then it disappears, it's clear, but it's sticky. And so using an old sheet of foil that I used on a previous package or previous piece of art, I'm just using up the remnants to basically cover up those little spots, and the glue just holds on to the foil, peel it right off, and then voila, it's stuck to your paper. So we're just going to do that all over the whole thing as much as I can with this, and then I'll get another piece of foil because, I mean, you can use up scraps so much, you know. And it's a little bit of work to use up a scrap piece of foil, but you can't waste that stuff, right? I mean, it literally is gold. So anyway, I don't know if that was gold or copper. I think it is gold, though. It sure looks gold. So yeah, we'll just make sure we got it all. And then it's really, really easy to use. I mean, you just make sure that it's clear. And because I use this specific kind of glue, it's still tacky. And there are glues out there that will stay tacky even once they're a little dry. And those work the best. But yeah, it's just a neat thing to add. And look at how magical this thing looks already with that gold on top of it. I mean, every layer just adds a little bit of something extra. This would make a really neat background for a focal point, almost jungle-like, or a painting of a Asian woman's face, maybe. But that's not the plan. We're making 12 ATCs in 1 hour. And shoot, I'm making them in less than 25 minutes, so. I did speed this up to double time, so that is kind of cheating, but I'm not counting it. Are you counting it? All right, so a little bit of black gesso on our palette there to the right, and another art foamy stamp. I like this one because it's like an illegible script. I think it's by, oh, I can never say her name. I can never say the name of the woman who designed this. Balzar or something. I don't know what her name is. Julie, I think is her name. Anyway, applying it with the brayer, and it does give it a little hit and miss, but I'd prefer to just plop it in there and yep. And then I do turn it around, and then this again is me making sure that every one of the places we're going to cut into an ATC has a smidgen of each element that we add. So that's why you see me randomly stamping here and there, just to make sure that everywhere we cut is going to have some of this element on it, the black element on it. It doesn't have to be legible. It doesn't have to be a full focus image. It's just about it being, about it touching that 2.5 by 3.5 inch area. And, you know, in the past, I marked out where those areas were, so I knew where to put specific imagery and whatnot. But after you do this a little while, you kind of figure it out. It's all going to end up if you just randomly go all over the thing like you see me doing. So now the tough part, because to maximize the amount of ATCs you're going to get out of one thing, you have to kind of look ahead a little bit and then decide what you're trimming off. And you notice I have this blue line that I've got the paper up against, and then there's a red line just below it on my trimmer. Excuse me. Those lines, I purposefully took a paint pen and marked them on my cutter, so that way I knew those were the two different measurements I need for ATCs. I make a lot of ATCs, and it's something I love to do, so I wanted to make sure that I had those guides on my trimmer at all times. And there's a little bit of a white line as well, and sometimes I'll use those white lines. Those white lines are just a smidge over. I don't know if it's an eighth of an inch or a 16th of an inch, but I'll use them sometimes to allow myself a trim so that I can get the best, how do you say it, the best edge So if you're up against an edge that isn't quite finished, you leave that and then you can trim it off. I don't know if that makes any sense. It did in my head, but notice how each one of these pieces has a smidgen of the green gold, a smidgen of the teal, a smidgen of the stamps. I mean, and it looks purposeful when you cut them down like this, but you watch the whole process. You know it was random. So pretty cool. Some of them look a little bit more interesting than others, but I think for the most part, they're pretty cool. There's no reason I'm doing ones to the right, ones to the left. It's just habit of where it ends up falling when I put them down. And I think we get more than 12 out of this, don't we? See how cool that looks? It all has the gold on it and everything. Woohoo! And we still have those little bits over on the right that you can make stuff out of. They go great on card fronts as, you know, just little accents or whatever. But look at that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Way more than 12. Nice. And so then I took a picture, and I always post pictures on Instagram when I'm live so people can get a better view, because the live stream camera, you know, I mean, I'm using a webcam. It doesn't pick up what our fancy cameras can pick up. And plus, it's a live stream. You're dealing with internet and everything else. So I always take pictures and then post them on Instagram. And that was a picture of the Instagram picture that I posted of them all cut out. And then I'm just using stickers. That's it to finish them off. The only thing that I would recommend if you're going to do these kinds of things is you might consider giving yourself a border of some kind, maybe taking a black marker or swiping with some black paint or something of that nature. There's lots of options out there to just finish it off, frame it off. You could even mat it onto a black cardstock. That gives the back of it a nice finish look too, if you're looking at doing that. Artist trading cards are just a really neat way to get a little piece of an artist. And I recommend, if you're curious, to look up sometime artist trading card and the history of how it came about. There's lots of people who claim one thing or another, but I think the research is a little bit interesting to find out how people have adapted it over years and all kinds of fun stuff. So for me, artist trading cards are fun to collect. I super love making them. I've even joined a couple of groups over on MeWe, which is a social media app that I really enjoy being a part of. And I've joined a couple clubs over there where we just swap with each other. And I've enjoyed receiving some pretty cool ATCs from some new friends I've made over there. I'm also working on doing some sort of ATC swap with my members on my website, and I hope that other people are also interested in that, because I can't wait to collect other people's art. I think the hardest part about this is finding matching words and focal points that you want to add on, but you know, if you buy a paper pack and then, or a sticker pad or something from Michael's, let's say, and then you make your ATCs that match those colors that are on that sticker pad, it's pretty easy. And they don't have to go one way or the other. You can make them horizontal, you can make them vertical. They're the coolest thing. So yeah, this is the section where I'm saying to myself, do I really want to be doing these voiceovers? I hope that the people listening to this appreciate it. And if they do, I'll keep doing them. But otherwise, standing here talking to myself is kind of a weird thing. I mean, I'll only do it if that's what you want. So let me know down in the comments if you enjoy a voiceover or if you prefer the music. So whether it's music you like or not, I don't really care because you can mute it and put your own on if you want. These are all super cool though. I'm very much thinking that I want to do an ATC swap each month, but I'm not totally sure how to go about that. So if that's something you're interested, maybe join my email newsletter, because that's where I'm going to be talking about it and asking people if they want to participate. So that's found on our website, which is craftshack.com, and just join the newsletter there, and you get to be a part of things as well. All right, so that pretty much wraps it up. You can see all of the ATCs that I created. Hopefully you enjoyed all of this. And we'll catch you next time. Have a crafty day.